Jacqueline, I'm in Cooney, your Art Sherpa, and today we're going to paint Jack Skellington and Santa Claus. You guys asked for this a lot, like a lot since Halloween, just to make sure that I came back and did a Christmas pass at Jack, because I know some of you are really, and I feel you, because I love the idea of putting up Christmas decor at Halloween and then just going through January. On the mic today is my husband, John.
Hi, guys.
If you're brand new here, what we do is we show you how to do a painting. This isn't a you watch me paint a painting show. This is you follow along while I describe how you should be doing this painting at home. I'm going to give you a lot of options, a lot of variations, let you know some exchanges. Pretty much, we're going to cover the techniques of how to paint Jack in. There is a link to a Traceable below. If you go to TheArtSherpa.com, you can find more information about these videos. You can find the Traceable. I don't think drawing is the necessary entry to art. It's great to learn. There's a lot of great places to learn it. But if it's not your thing today, let's still paint. I want to say hi to all the little brushes who are at home.
The little brushes. We have lots of little brushes. I'm pushing buttons back here. Just having a fun time.
John is pushing buttons. John reads the comments. I don't see the comments. So when you guys are commenting, John reads it. Our moderators, those are the people with the wrenches. They help figure out what's happening with the comments, try to help get John's attention. Sometimes they've been here so long, because many people have been here since the beginning, they might actually even know an answer to a question that you have.
A lot of times they do.
Yeah, a lot of times they do, because they've been maybe on their 200th, 300th painting. It's been a bit of a journey for all of us. We're kind of a few paintings in.
We're
kind of like art on YouTube over here.
We have a huge room with us today.
Do we? Because we like Jack.
And we do. There's a lot. And we have a lot of little brushes with us here. So I'll say we have Hunter and Zachary and, and let's see here. Little brushes, Harper and Porter and Kiki. And it's a happy seventh birthday to Zoe. Oh, my gosh. There's just so many here. I'm going to have to go through and collect all these up here.
I want to say hi to Aiden today.
Oh, yeah, Aiden. And we have all of our, over 200 brushes with us in the room, and it just keeps growing and growing.
We have some Australian brushes. And
we have lots. I like our Aussie brushes.
Our Aussie brushes. Our brushes from down under.
Our Kiwi brushes.
Our Kiwi brushes. We do both here. I'm sorry. It's just mostly because we just want to come visit
and
you.
Our Swedish brushes.
Our Swedish brushes.
Who are the best outdoors, like, you know, carve it yourself brushes. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm going.
We're
hide
just
all
having
our
such a fun day. Hi, all right, buddies. So today's going to be acrylic paint. Yeah. I'm going to tell you what I'm using. I'm going to tell you what the brushes I'm using. But listen, remember, you guys don't have to, if you have a different red, your painting won't explode. It'll just have a slightly different red to it. That's all that happens from that. So don't have a panic. We're painting on canvas board today.
Yeah,
got right. So these are the nice little boards that you can get. That helps with storage, because I know many of you are on so many paintings that you're having some storage stuff. And you can still frame these.
That's right over your face. I'm gonna move that away. Hold on, I'm gonna go. That's just it. That's just stepping on you. All right.
We always put wishes on our canvas, and today I actually pre-collected wishes. This canvas is going to be dedicated to these wishes and everybody going through this. This is for Carrie, Joan, Sandra, Laura, Stephanie. And all of you out there that are going through mental health issues right now, you know, depression is something that happens to everybody. I've gone through depression. Yeah. John's been through several because he's chronically ill. If you have chronic illness, chances are at some point you're going to not feel happy. Your brain chemistry is going to change. You're going to have a chemical cascade. And I just want to say, if you're going through depression, you're not alone. A lot of people go through it. There's nothing, I mean, there is something that you should check with your medical health care, because you deserve to feel okay. But just know this isn't a willpower issue. This isn't a, you know, suck it up and feel better kind of a thing. Sometimes all of us, even little brushes, go through a hard time, like if we're bullied at school. That happens to everybody, and it can be even harder during the holiday season. So let's all take a deep breath. Let it out. And realize that we can lean on each other and support each other. I don't know what you're doing over there. Oh. John was like looming, and I'm like, what's broken? Like, I'm probably talking and nobody's hearing anything. But just know I've been through it. John's been through it. Community members have been through it, getting a lot of messages about it. And so my wish is that you have supportive people around you that support you and understand this is a medical condition. This isn't a bad attitude. That makes me so crazy.
Yeah.
When people treat it like it's a bad attitude, like you just got a bad attitude. This is a medical condition. There is help. I hope you have people around you that are supporting you. Art can help. Many of you are saying that it's so bad right now you can't paint. And what I'll say is that's okay. That happens to people too. Just hang in. Hold on. It's going to be okay. All right, let's get this painting in.
While you're getting, I'm going to say thank you to all of our moderators who are here with us. We've got, like, I've seen Mark Muir's joined us, and Bonnie and Colleen.
Hi, Mark.
And all you guys, really, really appreciate it. And Flame, and you know, you guys, we couldn't do this without you. So thank you so much for all your help.
Now, I have this little kind of, I think this is a one-inch brush here. These are not expensive. This is a stiff white nylon. What's nice about these is they're not too thick, and this filament is very firm, and it doesn't overtake in water. So even when I dip it, John's fixing my P's and T's. We have some sharpness issue in our sound thing. So even if I dip it in the water, it's not going to take in too much, right? So I've got that going. I might even add out what I call, what they call, I didn't make this, I'm not associated, acrylic glazing liquid gloss. That could change the name, I don't know, but basically this is Golden's Glaze and Retarder. And what that means is that I can do thin glazes and it slows the drying time of my paint.
Right.
Now, both. I'm going to just load a little on my brush and come over and get some of my phthalo blue. Oh, I got to tell you guys the colors.
Oh, and you got to do, start. Well, you forgot a couple things there, Sherpa.
No, I did wishes.
What about telling us how to sketch this in?
That's right. I did forget a couple things. You got me there. All right. How we draw Jack in.
Okay,
thank you, John.
You know what? I have to say that I was reminded by those in the room because I was like, all right, we got to get to paint. I'm all excited to paint today. and then they were like, but wait, how do we draw?
How do we draw it in? It's cool we don't. For those that, if you don't want to draw, that's okay. But for those of you whatever size canvas you're on, this is our 11 by 14, but I'm going to tell you about what you're looking for. So when you sketch in your circle that is the head, make sure that your circle leaves a little space on this side here and goes just a little bit over, just a smidge, a hair over the halfway mark. You want it to be kind of a little bit, I'm going to sketch this in harder so you can see it, flattened, right? Sometimes we call this foreshortened. It's like a little squish circle. It's an oval. This is going to be funny in my paint. I'm just trying to make it where you guys can really, really see it because sometimes the camera doesn't always see what we've got going on. So we get that little circle in, right? Now you'll notice when I put him in, I had a neck coming down that I'm going to take my beard over. And there's just a little bit of his red suit down here showing. These little shoulders will come off. His beard actually comes down below his chin. Leave a little space between his head and the beard. Follow along the head shape. And then you're going to tuck it back into his head like a smile. I'm going to come off here and wander down. And how I do this is I bring this over, and I just do a swirl, right, at first. So that way when I come back, I can actually follow along this first line. And that's how I get a nice swirl. And I'm going to just bring this line down to join it. Now, on his face here, inside his circle, his eyes, if you notice this, they're a bit like a triangle shape, aren't they? So if you even had trouble drawing, you could put in some triangles to kind of get a sense of how it is. This is the gesture of his eyes. We've talked about gesture before.
Gesture.
If you want to know more about things like gesture, you can always join the big art quiz, which is every Thursday.
Oh, yeah.
Right? So once I know the shape that he's got these sort of triangle eyes, then I create the little weird bean eye, which kind of comes in, goes out, comes around. Because Jack's eyes, even though he's a skeleton, are quite flexible and expressive, which I think in real life would be really freaky, to be honest. I think that would disturb any of us if we saw bone being all squishy. And then I like to do a thing on the nose where one nostril is just a little bit smaller, and it's kind of like a teardrop shape. When I come down here, I come way, way, way down the head, very close to the jawline. I'm going to smile. I'm going to come down, and I'm going to make a slight deviation like a hill going up. Slight, right? And I'm going to bring it back up here. Now, his hat is sort of neat. Some of the hat goes right off our canvas. Whatever size canvas or paper you have, take the hat off a little bit. And then imagine that it's traveling up here, but then it comes down, it goes down, it goes down. And then it goes up like a roller coaster. It's like a hill. And it's going to curve down. See how this makes a nice shape right here?
Mm-hmm.
So when I'm coming off the side of his head, I want to be about the same size as side as I was on the other side. I'm going to bring this around and slowly merge it in. I'm not going to worry about drawing in the tassel or the fur yet. We're the little black lines. Okay? Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to get this brush out, double dip, do all my stuff, everything I said before, get my phthalo blue.
Now, hold on. Because I want to put a couple more things in there. We got birthdays, and they've got a really special message from Priya that I want to make sure
Priya.
We get in there.
How are you doing?
She got engaged early today, this morning.
Congratulations, Priya. So congratulations. That's amazing.
Can you totally just put a little wish in there for Priya and a happy marriage? Because I think, you know, she's been one of our viewers with us. And I really, I love when our community has something like this happen and we can be a part of it. So thank you for sharing
with
us.
Thank you, Priya.
And congratulations. And we all...
Make them paint on your bridal shower. Make them paint. We should do a bridal shower painting.
We should do something there. That'd be fun. All right. So Priya, you should tell us, give us some ideas. What do you think we should be doing here?
Yeah, we should totally do that.
All right.
We're just going to get bridal showers, get all those people painting. I mean, you could go to a spa. That's good too.
Yeah, we'll do something. All right. So go back. Tell us about your painting, your colors now.
So what I've got is phthalo green, phthalo blue. I have an interesting color here. I have a cobalt violet hue. Mm-hmm. I have titanium white. I have cadmium red medium. If you're painting with kids, always paint hue. And if you're painting with student paint, guess what? You are painting hue. Mm-hmm. Cad yellow medium. And again, you can get this in hue or in the regular cad paint. And I've got my glazing medium here. Listen, we're not mixing paint today. So on this, because I was asked this, could this be ultramarine?
Could it be?
Yes, it could.
It could be?
It could be. This could be any purple you have. This can be any red you have. This can be any yellow you have. This can be any green you have. And this can be any white you have.
Is that because this is a pop art piece?
It's more pop art, and it doesn't require a lot of mixing. And so, yeah, you might have a slightly different red, or your red might be darker, your red might be oranger. Those things you might be dealing with. But if you've got whatever you've got right now in your little art kit, go ahead and make that okay.
So I guessed correct.
Hmm?
I guessed right.
You did.
I was. I'm getting better at this game.
All right, I'm going to just paint right over what I drew in because I have made this so dark. It is never going away. It's going to show through.
So you're
going
to have to work it.
I'm going to, well, on this particular piece, it's okay.
Is it?
Yeah, some pieces it's a big deal. Some pieces it's just not even a big deal at all. I'm just going to go back and forth with my brush, right? I love this. You'll notice that I dip in some water here, take off the excess, come back and get some more paint. Right, it's been sitting out, so I'm going to get a little of my glazing medium so I can just keep going. I'm not worried about painting darker at the top and lighter at the bottom. I just want to cover the entire canvas in paint. Whose birthday was it?
Oh, we had a couple of birthdays. I think James, we had a birthday for.
Happy birthday, James.
A little brush Zoe had a birthday.
Happy birthday, Zoe. I want to say hi to Millie.
Oh, yeah. Always high fives there. Millie. And let's see here. I saw some other folks. I'm going to scroll up and see.
Wyatt. Brooke.
Lots of congratulations
Emma.
For Priya out here.
Emmy. Sorry. I'm just going back and forth trying to create a nice, smooth blue background. Kind of background. I'm dipping again, taking off the extra. And again, it doesn't overwhelm my brush because of how this brush is made. Mm-hmm. When you're looking for brushes, you are looking for how it's made and if it's made for what you're doing. You know, is this a good watercolor brush? Is this a good oil brush? Are these things made for that? And you guys know never, ever to put synthetic fibers in turpentine.
Oh, yeah.
Because it will melt them. That's what bristle brushes are for. And bristle brushes sometimes get too soft when I'm painting for heavy body paint, even though they feel just right in the store.
That's because water softens them.
Hmm?
Water makes them soft.
Water makes them softer. You've ever had that happen to you? And you're like, it was so stiff in the store. And now it's not. And I don't know what happened. I must have broken my brush.
So Tamantha has a quick question here.
Hi, Samantha.
Oh, no, it's Tamantha.
Tamantha. Hi, yeah. Tamantha.
Cool name. So she says, can you paint the background, then trace Jack in after it dries?
Yep.
Is that okay?
That's okay, too.
Wait, no. We have to do it in the order.
That's okay, too.
Really? Oh, little
yeah,
brush.
I like to do it against the white background sometimes, not all the time, but so that you can see it.
Little brush Liam has a birthday.
Hi, Liam. Happy birthday. How old is Liam?
I would ask.
I love these live paintings. I hope to see lots of Jacks this year, next year, every year. If you guys like this, I'll do the whole town. I'll get all the characters.
Now, why?
Every year we'll go back and visit this idea and paint and paint and paint.
Why is it you're painting right over your drawing?
Well, I'm not losing the drawing. You can kind of see the lines right there, can't you?
Yeah.
I have very good paint. I have what's called Heavy Body Pro Paint. Doesn't mean it's actually that much more expensive than student paint, to be real honest. Sometimes with student paint, it's hard to paint over things and not have the color go through.
Right.
But on mine, I can do that. If you have really inexpensive paint, you might want to paint around him very carefully with your blue. That's a tip.
Oh, so you're
if
not...
If your paint was real cheap and came in a big, giant, awesome box of all the colors, which is fun. I know I always look at that box and think, that looks like fun. If your paint did that, though, you might want to paint around your drawing, your blue around your drawing.
Gotcha. So you're not worried about it because you know that the whites and things will cover the blue later.
Yeah.
And
that's the first paint I would upgrade if I was going to upgrade my paint.
Yeah.
If I was going to use my sale coupon for something.
Yeah.
I would absolutely upgrade my titanium white.
Oh, yeah.
That's my first one I would do.
I see Miss Angela Anderson here with
hey!
Us.
Hey! Everyone send Angela Anderson some love and healing. She's under the weather.
Mm-hmm.
As is actually Honey.
Oh, yeah.
And by the way, if you guys hang in, there's a... not that it's important on YouTube anymore, but at 300 likes,
that's right.
We actually have a new visitor who might come visit you if we get there. I'll probably show you.
Well, we have actually, we're closer to being Sherpa right now. We have
245
people.
Whenever we get there, not only got to dance, but I'm gonna drop on you the cutest thing you've ever seen.
Oh, you're going to bring Twix
in your life.
Okay, so
I'm not saying Blendy has a brother, but
I'm not good at secrets.
Oh man. I'm gonna draw on my canvas and let John talk to you while you guys go get your friends and say, hey, like this weird YouTube video that you don't watch because I want to see what she's got in the back room.
So I want to say thank you guys. We have like over 250 people here and 200. Wow, the likes are just skyrocketing. So thank you guys. Really appreciate all of you guys, the love and the support. We really do love seeing you. And we had some really great messages that were shared on the Facebook channel and to our YouTube. And I just wanted to say thank you to you guys. I'm going to go over here. And it was Ash. So Ash, thank you for all the kind messages. Really wanted to just thank you. You know, there's so many of them that come in and really appreciate that. So, you know, thank you for being here with us. And, you know, don't forget to tell your friends so we can do more stuff here. And there's the Sherpa, so I don't have to be alone here. Hi, Sherpa.
You're not that alone. No. I'm going to switch out my water and get my tiki tiki sippy sippy.
Tiki tiki sippy sippy.
Water.
So.
Hydration. Although I feel like I watched Adam Ruins Everything, and I'm not even sure I got to drink any of this.
Oh, you know what I do need to remember to do is like remind everybody to go out and hang out at TheArtSherpa.com where all of the people are and we have live chat working and mobile chat is working and new features are coming and you have all the space that you need to upload all your pictures and hang out with all of us and our friends and Cinnamon and I are out there a lot and we're all doing stuff there after the events here. So please, please, please come hang out with us.
TheArtSherpa.com and there's votes. Sometimes we do giveaways. There's crazy blogs. There might be extra pictures of the cute that's coming. I don't know. Stuff is going to happen. Ooh, so we're going to talk videos. About Dobbers and stencils.
Okay, yeah, talk about that.
So this is a really fantastic stencil. Okay? This thing is the bomb. And the reason this is the bomb is these bristles aren't going to break. You know how sometimes when you get these, they're real brittle? There's a whole horrible story I will tell you sometimes on why they're brittle. But these are not. And so this is one way you could do this. You could go right into your glazing medium and a little bit of your white, right? And if you're painting, again, student paints, you probably don't even... have to have the glazing medium. And you can do this sort of twirl. And you can get kind of a bokeh effect, right? We talked about this. That we were going to do a bokeh. But you can see it's kind of a little... It can be a challenge to do this way. Right? And it's really dependent on your stencil. This is cut incredibly well. So it's going to give me a fairly flat round circle. Let me make sure. Then you can see me cleaning. If you ever wondered how to clean your stencil brush...
You have to show me here on the
You go dip, dip, dip in your water.
I can't see the water.
Dip,
there
you go. Dip, dip, dip. The edges, not all the way up the ferrule in your water.
Yeah.
And then you come over here. I'll show you over here. And you just rub it back and forth on your towel. And then it's completely clean.
Oh, I see.
And you still need to wash it after. Dobbers. I'm going to bring the Dobbers over to the up-close cam.
Okay.
These are Dobbers. And many companies make Dobbers. They're kind of like different sizes of bingo stampers, right?
Yeah.
And the Dobbers are the easy way to do bokeh because they got different sizes. All the sets come with a variety of sizes.
Uh-huh.
All the sets, like, are easy to clean. All the sets are kind of, you know, this one was the hardest to clean, but I think it's because I just left it on too long.
Right.
Now I'm going to grab a Dobber. I'm going to grab this Dobber. Okay. I'm going to get this Dobber, and I'm going to, do I have any tape?
Yeah. Hold on a second.
I'm going to tape these as I go. So I'm going to get this Dobber, and I'm going to create this bokeh effect. If you're not familiar, bokeh is the sort of out-of-focus, beautiful filter, and it happens in photography. And it's really trending right now in art because it gives you these dots. We did it on the bokeh butterfly, where we did it in a really beautiful painterly way, and we really painted the blended background. And just bring me the whole thing in tape because I got several sizes I got to do. Putting it in my bucket, and then we're all good. Okay, so I've got this, right? And my first one I'm going to want to do, and you can see me loading here. See how I'm doing this little twirl? Go in and go twirl, twirl. It's not really actually loading that much in. I can grab some of my glazing medium. I'm still twirling. Believe it or not, that's about all you're looking to do. And I'm going to go right over my drawing because I'm going to be painting over everything, and I want it to feel layered. Look at that. Get some more glazing medium. Super easy. Oh my gosh, this is easy. I can now paint all those things that I saw online that I thought were really cool. I don't have to stress out. And you know what? You can also twirl a brush if you feel like it. Trick on bokeh, if you're very good at color theory, you can change up the colors you use. But if color theory is hard for you, you know, knowing which colors go together really well, I'm going to bring a bokeh over here and twist. Notice I'm not reloading it that often. All right, I'm going to come up here, twist. And I'm even just having a moment just because on mine, my surface isn't flat. All right, because I got to teach you guys on the easel. Now, another thing that I could do is I could come get my purple, whatever your purple is. See my little purple there? Add it in. Because these are color harmonies, this is going to look good no matter what I do. If I start adding red or yellow or green in here, this could get crazy. But as long as I'm painting colors that are similar to my background, which is what a lot of bokeh filters do, I'm just adding that purple. I'm having to support, you can kind of see here, the back of my canvas. And notice that I'm layering my twirls, this twist, over my canvas. Now I'm going to dip this in my water, and then I'm going to kind of stamp this out. I just don't want the paint to be in my sponge too long. It can stain it, and you can go just like you are in a position where you could go walk away and go to your kitchen and just rinse these out as you go, right? But I am not, so I'm going to pick a different little dobby. I want a different size. I want a much smaller size. I want at least three sizes of what I'm doing, right? Because generally when you look at a bokeh filter, it's going to, fractal the light?
Well, it diffracts light. So the bokeh effect is actually caused by the light refracting off of the iris of the lens and the internal components of the lens to make those funny shapes. And that the artistic defocusing of the lens is actually called bokeh. Oh, there you are. I couldn't see what you were doing there.
Yeah, just making sure. So it doesn't. Everybody's little craft store has some versions of these.
Yeah.
Right. Get a version that's, you know, not hard on your pocketbook. I put a lot of purple on there. I'm going to get my glazing medium. And look, I'm going to come back and do some different sizes. And one of the tricks is layer it over. Okay? Layer smaller circles over bigger circles. And also you want a couple that go out a little bit. Okay? To get that good effect. Doing this twirl and press on a firm surface is helpful. I'm going to come put some blue on here, just to mix up the colors. And when we looked at this, I found, and I think John found, that the cost between the different ones were pretty much, they all were about the same range. Didn't you find that, babe?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Because he
did.
Ran the Bokeh errand. I was go get me some Dobbers.
And, you know, they it didn't really matter who made them or what. They all seemed to be about the same price. So it was just sort of a matter of, what are you doing there? Oh, you're cleaning it.
No, I'm just cleaning it. This is the no-fail Bokeh.
Yeah. You just seem to, you know, they seem to be about all the same price. Just sort of figure out which one you liked and then kind of going with it. Because they're all just sort of foam. There were some in the dollar pack. There were some in very expensive packs. But, again, it's just a piece of foam on a stick. So.
It really is. I bet you could even craft one out with a sponge. So I'm just placing this around like I've got a smaller size now. Right? Smaller size. You can pick up some of your Just Purple. I'm going to get some Just Purple. I haven't rinsed my brush. Some of your Bokehs can be see-through. Like as the sponge dries out, I'll make some of them more see-through. You can be as decorative. I'm going to kind of move this on its side so I have better access. Always try to layer. See how I'm always like trying to overlayer them? That's a helpful thing. That's a nice little arrangement. So, see, that's a beautiful, you get it where you like it. You get it where it makes you happy. I'm taking my Bokeh bubbles right into my guy, into my Jack.
Why are you doing that?
So that when I paint him in, it creates the illusion of depth.
Oh, so you're planning on painting right over some of those.
And I'm not speeding along today. I was speeding earlier, but then I remember we're gonna be chill today because we got kids painting with us.
Oh, yeah.
And we got people painting with us. I don't need to be full Sherpa speed, which is like full steam ahead. So just look around, and you just keep adjusting this. Now, even from here, you could go back with this technique, right? And just keep bokeing until an infinite amount of bokeh until it was just some crazy abstract layered piece. And we may look at that later. Because these are fun. These are easy. By the way, on a lot of these, like, where it'd be hard to clean, these things come out.
Oh, yeah?
And you can really, really.
Oh, cool.
Really, really, really remove.
Oh, it makes it so that you can really clean those.
So it's easy to do, easy to clean, just not a problem. And then the next step, I got to actually, believe it or not, dry this again.
Oh, yeah.
With my hair dryer.
Cool. So I would say thank you to all of you guys who are hanging out. I'm going to go over and take a look at this because I've been, you know, oh, wow. You guys, we are almost Sherpa out here. So thank you so very much. We have so many likes and comments. Thank you guys for all coming here and hanging out with us. Really appreciate that. You know, we love for you guys coming out and hanging out at TheArtSherpa.com. We're doing all those wonderful upgrades and stuff. And Kim would like to see some Texas snowflakes. All right, I'll see what I can do here. I'll see if I can get that going while we're... when Cinnamon comes back here and starts to work, I'll sneak around in the back and see if I can turn those on. So while we're doing that, don't forget to go out and tell us your stories and post your pictures. I love seeing all the pictures that you guys do and all the stories the little brushes painting along with us. So please, please, please post those up for me because I love seeing them. I love being able to share that. So, yeah, thank you guys. And I hope you're all having a good day. It's been, you know, pretty crazy Saturday. We're all hanging out here, just really just pleased that we get to do this. So, hey, you.
Couldn't be easier, could it?
Yeah, no.
It's seriously, I love the stencil thing that I did with the butterfly, and I love the blending, and I do think that that absolutely has a place because you can get some really subtle shaded effects. But I have to say, for just this effect, if you're journaling, if you're making cards, if you're just painting like this, this is the way to go. We're going to do this again because this was too much fun. Oh, yay, Texas snowflakes. It's actually what gave me the idea. I was like, now this is a number 8 bright. This has a double crib ferrule. It's triple glued. It's got a synthetic filament that isn't going to overload with water. A nice edge. Bright is different than a flat because a flat will be much longer and softer and won't necessarily work with heavy bodied paint as well. So that's why I really, really like a bright. That's what it is. You can totally paint with a flat. They have a purpose. There's a whole reason why they're out there. They're fantastic. But you can just see that this brush doesn't sop up too much water. So when I go to work with my paint, it really, really just pulls it out. I love Texas snowflakes. And you can kind of see the load on it. It loads at the... this just makes me so happy. Does this make you so happy? It makes me so happy. All right. Bubbles, bubbles. And then I got fixed up. And I'm just going to paint in my hat space. What I sketched in for my hat, guys. Right? Just paint it in. If you're painting with economy paints, and there's nothing ever wrong with doing that, okay? You've got to respect your budget in your art process. All right? I tell you what I'm painting with so you know how I'm getting the result. But, you know, the bank account matters.
Oh, yeah.
It does, even in our hobbies, even in our passions. You know, and so you got to make what you can do work. So if you are painting economy paints, how they get that cost down is in the pigment. So you may need to do two coats on the red, is all I'm saying. Maybe three.
Gotcha. And that's okay.
And that's okay. And you may need to let the bottom layers cure. There's just some tricks to painting with economy paints. I, however, am spoiled, and I just want my stuff to cover and be painted red and just be like the reddest red that was ever red. So I paint golden paint a lot, or at least, you know, Matisse golden, Liquitex professional heavy bodied. You know, I'm going to come down here and also paint in this little bit of red that I have peeking out. This is a balance issue when I do things like this. It's because it balances the painting. The red up here ties in nicely with the red down here. And it also lets you know he has a body and a suit that's going off the canvas that maybe you're not seeing.
Gotcha.
Okay, that's all. Do, 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 do. It can be hard to rinse red out of a brush. So you may need to switch brushes or go rinse your brush really, really well. You might need to. I'm going to paint in his face, though, and I'm going to grab some just white paint and start painting in Mr. Skellington's face. I might lose my smile.
And that's okay.
That's okay. I can put it back. I know where it was.
Kind of know where it goes.
Yeah. Oh. Don't panic about those things. The nice thing about traceables, a lot of times when you make them, even when it's your own designs, like if you guys follow Angela or you follow Lindsay, you'll see that they made their own traceable from their original design. They sketch it out ahead of time, right? Work it out on paper, and then transfer it to canvas so that they don't have, like, a crazy hot mess moment.
So Little Brush Liam had a message for you that I was going to pass along.
Okay.
He says, Liam would like Cinnamon to know that she's a really good painter.
Thank you, Liam. I really appreciate that. And I think it's really cool you're painting with me today. I hope you like the bubbles.
Thank you.
I like them.
And I really like seeing Liam's paintings. So I hope we get to see some more of that come up.
Yeah, very, very much. Share the paintings. Share the paintings. I'm kind of leaving the little sketch I did of the nose. I might have to change it up, you know, as I'm painting around. I use the shape of my brush to get around my edges. Like, so when I want to get on an edge here like this, I can do it two ways. I can come along and use this outer hair of my brush.
Okay.
Or I can use the edge of my brush. And because this is pretty well made bright, both of these lines are very, very controlled and don't flay out on me too much.
Real sharp.
They are. They are real sharp. It can be harder. Like if these bristles get longer and longer and longer, that could be an area it gets harder.
Oh, yeah.
But, you know, if I'm doing like smooth, flat fields with a soft body paint.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Nothing like a good flat. So all brushes belong in your brush bin.
Oh, yeah.
And they all need your love and your care. My New Year's resolution is going to be to take better care of my brushes.
Yeah.
To be a better brush mama. Have we gotten there? Have we gotten to our 300 so we can show our surprise?
We are so close, but I think we could probably...
Oh, my gosh. I'm dying to show my surprise.
I hear it in the background. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let you finish up your field of white here and getting some of that in there. And then maybe we'll do a little bit of the white on the beard because you're already in the white.
Yeah. We've got to get everything.
So you get all your white in and then we'll bring our guest out because I think that'll be about the right time.
It'll be about the right time.
Yeah.
All right, we got to get a little net going here. Imply that he's attached to his own head, though. Sometimes he takes his head off, by the way.
Which is a fine thing to do when you're a skeleton.
Yeah. And I want to point out, is what we were talking about earlier, about sometimes feeling sad. Jack felt sad.
Jack
was the pumpkin king, and he felt sad.
He was feeling a little
little down. Like lost in his life, thinking that maybe Santa Claus had it better.
Yeah, he didn't know. He thought the snow was greener.
And you can see how my titanium white really powers over that blue.
Oh, it does.
Just powers over it.
What's funny is that it's so bright, it almost causes the camera to crush the whites because it's so bright.
Does it?
Yeah, it's really interesting.
I'm going to come here and just make sure that my edges are nice. And then I will paint in my beard. My beard, my happy. Not a glitter beard. It could be, though. You could glitter this beard.
I have donned the glitter beard.
You have donned. We do also have black as a color. It's not out because we're using a soft body black today.
Uh-huh.
But we do have black as a color as well. These things are always in the description. Everything we're using on the materials, we try to put in the description.
We try.
The only time that it isn't is because we had to come back on YouTube now, live now, because something happened with our stream.
Yeah.
And it gives us this weird thing where it says, greatest painting in the world, which it's not. But John, you know, he titled those. And
it was just generic, like, you know, what are you going to put in as your generic title? It's like, I don't know, greatest painting in the world. And it was just supposed to be a filler. And it was like, little did I know that when you push the button, it automatically populates all your stuff. So it's like,
oh. I'm going to do this in these kind of like chunky strokes. And I'm going to allow some of my blue underneath to show through to create tone and value. So this feels fluffy.
Fluffier.
It feels fluffier. Isn't that fun?
Mm-hmm.
Just don't have to be that crazy about these things. These are... So sometimes art is, you know, fine art, and sometimes art is fun art.
Yeah.
But all art is art. And we're never wasting our time when we're doing art. We really aren't. It's crazy to me when people see art as a waste of time.
Yeah.
This is when I get my head straight. This is when I figure out how to solve all the weird problems in my life that are eluding me. This is maybe the best time I spend all day.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You know? This is like a bran muffin for your soul, except it's tastier and funner. Somebody needs to work on that bran muffin thing. really, because it isn't working. But it's bran. Yes, it is. I used to feed that to my horses so they'd have a good poop. So I'm just bringing this around.
I'm glad we have little brushes with us today, because there's nothing like talking about a horse poop on painting day.
I'm just saying, that's how horses poop better.
Oh, man.
Poop is funny.
It's just universally, I think.
Universally, poop is funny. All right, look at that. How easy and fun
was
that?
That looks pretty good.
Now, the reason I haven't gotten the white up here yet is this has to be dry, or his fur will be pink. And he doesn't have pink fur. I'm going to wipe this off, and John's going to get the surprise. And so while we're letting that dry, so we had Blendy has a new sister. Blendy is a brother, and this is our really big thing that we had. It took a lot to get here because we had to remove all the sago palms from our yard and also create an indestructible flea barrier. We learned this when we had a guest staying with... No, you can bring her. We had a guest staying with us that we were babysitting, and so we learned that these things were all huge problems. So if you have sago palms, please know that they're poisonous to kids and pets. It's important stuff to know. Okay. Now, I really need your help because I got to know something. I have to know something. This is Twix. Twix is feeling sad, but it's okay because it can cuddle her. And you just went, oh, no.
She was napping.
She was napping? I bet my mic is super chewy.
Oh, she's, yeah, I'm sure
she
is.
I didn't think about that. Now, we don't know if she's right Twix or left Twix. You have to tell us.
You'll have to figure out. So we're gonna have to see how she goes. And oh, we have some more little brushes. I saw a little brush. Hold on. Zoe and Who else did I see here who was up there? Oh, Dalton. Happy birthday, Dalton.
Happy birthday. So this is our new little fur baby. Mm-hmm. And she's a King Charles poodle mix.
Yes.
And she's like, this is not her room. She likes the upfront living room where her toys and crunchies are.
Yes.
She likes crinkles.
Crinkles, yes.
She likes the things to go crinkle. She also likes to play hand under the blanket.
Mm-hmm. And she's about, like, what, 9 weeks old?
Yeah.
9, 10 weeks, somewhere in there?
Yeah.
So
she's going to be seeing our the family vet that sees her cousins. All right. Bye, sweetie. Thank you. Okay. You got it. This is beyond cute. It's all puppy all the time. Puppy cam. Fuzzy puppy. Oh, it's okay. You take the crinkles so she has it when she goes and plays. So that's our big news. And expect a lot of pictures of her doing artistic things. I'm kind of into it. So we waited a long time to get a family dog. And we had to take care of a lot of things to do that. And we finally got them all checked off so we can, and we are. This is not art related. So if you're like, what? But it's our big news. And we've been super excited. I've been wanting, as we've been counting down to bring Twix home, I've been wanting to post pictures. I've been wanting to share the excitement about her. But I've been like, you know, you just never know in the adoption of a puppy what will happen. And so I've been waiting, waiting, waiting. And she's here. And we're so excited. And I'm sure artwork. Okay, first of all, the little ruffy face. I love the little whiskery ruffy face. This is all going to come into art. This is going to impact the art. And now John's left me alone, which you wouldn't think makes me nervous, but it does. So I'll show you my hat. There we go. I've distracted you with an adorable hat. So I don't know, Bubbles. I don't know what the response to Twig is, but I have to assume it's
response. All the puppy love. Everybody definitely loves the puppy. So.
Oh, my gosh. Is she not the cutest thing you've ever seen? I'm going to put out some soft-bodied black here. I like this fluid black because I can thin black paint. I can thin heavy-body black paint with water or with a medium. But I like this little tube, and it's carbon, and it's a little bit shinier, and it flows off my brush really well. And believe it or not, they come in little tiny jars from this company as well. So you can get those. But you know what? Craft paint is also soft-bodied. So You just want the stuff that doesn't hold brush strokes. This hat is like feeling very folly off off today. So you're going to get to see my hair for a second because I'm having a little hat moment. Having a little hat moment, guys.
Got your awesome hat. There we go.
Got to get the double roller. She goes off. All right. I'm going to get a much smaller brush.
Okay.
I'm going to get, actually, I'm not sure.
Dalton says thank you for the wishes.
I'm going to get a round. This is a number 4 round. I'm going to switch to round. You could do a small bright, though. And I'm going to dip this in. I'm going to pull this out because, again, New Year's. Better care of brushes. I'm working on it. And while I'm letting everything dry, I'm going to load my brush up on the tip, right, about halfway up the bristles, and I'm going to enjoy just painting all of this in.
Gotcha.
Oh, it's drying. So I'd love to know some Twix comments.
Oh, man. There's so many people who want to see you do a painting of her. That would be so awesome.
I think we have to.
Yeah. Lots of people think that she is just so cool.
She's so playful, and she's so funny, and she's so sweethearted. And for poo-poo mirror, she pooped on me twice already, so I think we have to be buddies now.
Well, she was on her way home, and she was having a little... She was
stressful.
Having a moment. Yeah.
That's a stressful day. Try to make it not be stressful, but can be.
And she's real smart. She's already potty training pretty well. She's going right on the pee pads.
We're as close as she can get. Her best guess where the pee pad mostly is.
She's trying to back up to him, that's for sure. Uh-oh, what's happening over there? Why is that not switching for me?
Okay, I don't know. Are you good?
There it goes. Okay.
Okay, so you can see this. See how I'm just not working to get this to flow off? Right? This is no work for me. This is a lot the brush and the paint working together as a team. And not about me at all. I think the part about me is knowing that this particular body of paint and this brush will make this happen super easy. That's all that is. Now, if you have real thin paint and you notice that you've had a problem, one tip I can give you is to paint the bulb shape in the eyes white first.
Ah.
Once this is dry. If it's just been an issue. If it hasn't been an issue, don't worry about it. I'm so excited about her. Right Twix, left Twix, we don't know. She came named.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so.
Yes, that was very exciting. Let me scroll back up here. They want to see a photo. Ian would like to see a photo of her so he could sketch her.
I am going to post some. Now that it's out.
Yeah.
Now that the secret's sort of out of the bag, I'm gonna post some.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm gonna work my little thing here again where I come down. I can kind of still faintly see my line, so I'm going to just follow that again. I will do that, Anne. I would love that. She just makes me so happy, and I love her ruffled, muffled, little fluffle face. And I like when she pounces her little toys. She pounces them. I also think it's real funny. She's one of the dogs, and I think it must be, you know, sibling thing,
uh-huh,
where she gets her food and then she goes and eats that bite somewhere else and then goes back and gets another bite of food. It takes her forever to eat her food. I'm going to make the little cross up and down lines on his little face here.
Mm-hmm. Now, is there a reason why you don't buy the larger tubes of paint?
What do you mean the larger tubes of paint?
Well, so, you know, Fables was noticing that you use the sort of medium-sized tubes. Aren't they cheaper when you buy the giant
tubes?
Yes,
they are, but I have to drive downtown to get them.
Ah, so it's
and
hard to get the
bigger
tubes.
I go to my local little place.
And that's what they do.
That has them, and then I don't have to drive downtown. But I really sometimes like to drive downtown, and then I get...
Ah.
So if I'm going downtown, then I like this size. I don't like the jars because I never get lids on correctly enough, and mine always dry out.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha.
And then the other tube sizes are the choices that I'm given. I got to fluff the hair. And now I will use another bright. And this one will be a number 6 bright.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm going to moisten, load up, and then I'm going to just fluff it up. See, I'm fluffing it up.
Oh, yeah.
This is just... The brush itself, and I don't even care if like a little blue or a little purple, whatever I had in there gets in there, because then it just adds to the streak, right? I'm letting the body of the paint also kind of imply some of the fluffiness. Isn't that fun?
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to put some more out. I'm almost out. I have way too much yellow and green out for what I have to paint. I do that sometimes so you guys can see it. I don't recommend that paint plop size, though. That's just for me. I'm going to fluff this way as well. Fluff this way. She told me to fluff this way. Sorry. I've been telling weird jokes all week. Weird jokes. Strange week. So you can see how the texture of the paint helps give me that fur space.
Yeah.
If I can't see my fur, I can always add a little teeny tiny smidge of black and make sure that there's a little bit of that over his face. See how we're doing?
Oh, yeah.
So if it's not visible where, you know, it's white on white, you can do that. You can even do that if you need to in the beard. Okay, so don't feel afraid to do those things if you need to do those things. Doesn't take a lot to get the texture. I just want to keep it real bright, so I am resisting it. Now I'm going to come off the edge of the hat here, and I'm going to make the little puff. Your puff could be anyway. Mine is weird and kind of little whimsical, little floofy. As you know, it came from Halloween Town, so it's got to be a little bit odd, right?
Now, so Jack was the pumpkin king. He
yes.
was a skeleton, right?
He had a skeleton.
He was a skeleton body, and he had a ghost dog.
He had a ghost dog.
And he had
he could sometimes put a pumpkin on his head.
And his girlfriend was a Frankenstein doll.
Yeah.
Sally.
And they were meant to be.
They were meant
it's
to be.
It's a love story.
And so, yeah, so Jack, this Jack the skeleton guy here, he wanted to try on Santa Claus role. So he decided he went from Halloweensville.
So this is a cool thing. So this guy's, he's, you know, every year he does Halloween. He's like so great at it, but he's just feeling unsatisfied with his life. It's just too perfect. And he can't find joy and he can't find happiness and everything should be right. And he knows something missing, but he's not sure what it is. So he goes out to where the holidays are and he ends up accidentally in Christmas Town.
Uh-huh.
And he's like, what's this? And so there's this really cool song that you should go check out and Google called What's This?
Yeah.
Which this is based on, this actual scene with the Christmas eyeballs. But I just added the Christmas stuff because he goes and visits his friend Sandy Claus.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's a whole bunch of characters. And again, if we like this, like I'm going to try to make sure we have 31 days of Halloween next year. Like you can do 31 paintings. And so we'll come back and we'll visit other characters from Halloween Town.
Steffi definitely wants to paint the ghost dog.
Yeah, we're going to do the ghost dog. We're going to do the kids. We're going to do Oogie Boogie. I mean, that's a blacklight painting if there was one, right? So.
All right, so.
Okay, and we're blacklight painting tomorrow. I hope everyone's going to show up for Flame's birthday because it's Flame Gremlin's birthday tomorrow.
She requested that.
She did for a year, kind of like Mark requested zombies.
What you doing over there now?
Okay. So I'm trying to make sure that my eyeballs are placed where I want them to be because I want an eyeball here and I want an eyeball here and the bulb. I'm sketching it so you can see what I'm thinking.
Okay. I'm just trying
to put it in with paint because you need this to look like his interior eyeballs. You can do any shape of Christmas light you like, right? I just copied what they had in the animation. So then there's going to be a nice little curve line. This curve helps me plan my line curve off the canvas because it's got to feel like this is hung and going off the canvas. And then this one is red and this one is yellow, which means this one will be green. So it goes green, red, yellow, green, red, yellow. So the first thing I'm going to do is rinse out a small bright. I'm going to say it's this number two bright.
Number two bright.
By the way, these are really cool. really.
I like how you're having to hold on to your hat like you're in a wind tunnel.
I am in a wind tunnel. Wind tunnel of felted awesome. So I can come across here for the little cable, right? This is the electric cable.
Yep.
And I'm going to paint this across here. Painting the cable like you do.
Like you do, maybe.
Like we all do. Because we're all doing it. We're all painting the cable.
Paint the cable.
We're all going to meet up tomorrow to paint some black butterflies.
And Lisa Flame has been, she has a December birthday forum post going.
Does she?
So if you go out to theartsherpa.com and your birthday is in December, like there are many of us Capricorns floating around in here.
I guess that's true.
Yeah. So mine's a December birthday. And I
just real quick to let them know what I'm doing. I'm making a little stroke about this distance apart. And that's how I get the light bulbs in.
Oh,
okay. So just figure out what your distance is and commit to it. Making that little stroke. That's the top of the bulbs, and they are going to be the same distance as the top of your little light bulb here.
Gotcha.
They don't have to be perfect. But it is helpful. No, I'm just kidding. Totally art is not about perfection. It's about completion.
Oh, so they're gonna, here. As soon as you're done getting all those little caps
in. I got to get a little white on my brush, and then here's the trick. I come in here, and I do it with a little bit of gray. And then I can add a little touch of gray to my caps, and so it all feels like it went together.
Gotcha.
I'm going to rinse these out and paint these in. Yes, you were saying
okay,
something.
So can I get a request from you?
Yeah.
Could you hold your bracelet up there right in front of the blue? No, over in your palette cam. Go to the palette cam. Oh, there you go. Can you show them that? Can you rotate that around? They were really wanting to catch that. They thought that was a really cool little bracelet you had on.
Thank you.
So
daughter made it.
Show me the bracelet.
Even that she combined some stuff together and gave it to me and said, I made you a bracelet. So now I wear it. She styled it, I think is the correct term. Little Lunabella. So I'm just painting this in my red bulb. Right. So now I know if this is Texas snowflakes, if this is green, red, yellow, green, red, yellow. Now here's an issue. Because this red is going to be over my cap, I'm going to do something.
Okay.
I'm going to add a little yellow to it. So it'll still be red, but it's going to pop. Otherwise, it won't pop enough.
Ah.
Right? See? Otherwise, it would just not really be enough of a thing. So go ahead and just make sure. Yeah. You know me and patterns. I'm just making sure this half is more yellow, and that's going to help these two sort of stand out from each other.
That's cool.
So this one's yellow. These are fun, aren't they?
Yes.
All right. This one is just straight yellow. Yellow is one of your thinnest colors in your palette. And so if this is giving you grief and you can't get it to be yellow over the black, definitely paint it white first. Or add a little white to your paint to improve its coverage. You know what I mean?
I do.
So I got a little white there. I'll show you what I mean. See how that just covers so much better?
I'm going to zoom in on that. Yes, I do. It just covers it right up.
And it's on his eye. The next one can be more yellow. You can do this all the way through. So green, red, and now yellow.
Get up here and see that.
Same, we're a little downward thing. That's what we're doing.
Dope.
And then this one has to be yellow off there. And now we know where the greens are.
Oh, it's
great to do patterns. I like patterns. Now I'm going to not even rinse it off because I have yellow on my brush. And I'm going to get some green because I want it to be super duper bright. I'm going to paint right over here my green bulb. Look at that go in. Mm. Green! Get some more green. Yellow. You don't want any red in it because it'll gray it out. I'm going to make another green bulb. See, I put out way too much green paint. Now you see it. Now you're like, oh yeah, you totally did. Now, to get my glow on, I'm going to put my little brush aside here. Oh, wait, I got to pull these out because I'm taking better care of my brushes. Better care.
Get them all arranged.
Better care. And I'm going to grab kind of a stiffy brush. What you want is maybe one of, this is actually a bristle, great bristle. If I get it wet, it's going to soften. So I'm going to do what's called.
You know what? You know what time it is?
Is it Dancy Dance time? I gave him a puppy.
It is. It's totally Dancy Dance.
Okay, let's dance. You should move your body and move your mind.
And we wanted to say thank you, guys, because it really is important to remember to get up and wiggle your fingers and wiggle your toes and dance, because it helps remind you that your body is alive.
And it's a snowflake.
And that we're here, and we love being here with you. And when we get 300 people in the room or 300 likes, we like to just celebrate that we are Sherpa. So thank you guys for joining us, all the Sherpettes and all the people.
Because 300 of us can totally hold Sparta. Or something.
Well, we would paint a wall.
We would paint a wall and it would fool him.
Yeah.
It would fool Xerxes and he would just go home and be like, that's how Athens does it.
He'd be like, that's so pretty.
That's actually an old art joke that made sense to like two people in the room. They were like, that's so funny. Everyone else is like, wait, Athens came in. I thought it was Sparta. What are we talking about?
So thank you guys. Well, we dance and we bubble and we party. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, and I'll come over and I'll give Cinnamon a quick kiss because we like to do the bubble party.
Oh, you want to be in the bubbles too? They're cool. Don't add glycerin to your paint. I mean, you can, but.
It isn't necessarily
this is,
helpful.
This is a small amount.
This is bubble party glycerin.
This is bubble party glycerin, so, you know. It somehow doesn't count.
I'm taking
a little white and a little yellow dry on the brush, right? And if you come here, you can put a little, and this is about a soft brush pressure. See this?
Yeah.
And this will also help this light bulb pop. We're going to make a little glow off these bulbs because they are lit up and they glow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right here in the eyes, just a little bit. Right? Some glowing. A little white and a little yellow. Trick of this is the brush is dry, so the bristles are still stiff.
Let's see if I can push a button and make things
a little glow will grow your heart out. All right. Okay. Here we go. Isn't that easy?
That's just so nice.
Now I'm going to rinse out this brush because it can be soft right now. Softer. And I'm going to get just some white. And I'm going to go right in my bulbs. I'm going to go dash, dash. Do you guys see that?
I do. Alan had the best idea.
What?
So you know what we're going to call this?
What?
We're going to call this a bokeh party.
This is a bokeh party?
When we get the bubbles going and we
For when it's not like winter, so come summer. It's the bokeh party.
It's
let's
bokeh.
Bokeh. Let's bokeh. Let's bokeh all the bubbles because we bokeh. We noka. You know I totally get fun of for being so dorky.
We power bokeh is what we do.
You know what else we did?
What? We power robot?
Finished.
We are not. Look at that. You haven't signed it, though. I think you have to sign it.
I'm not going to put the black line here because I didn't like it, so I'm editing that.
You're editing?
Uh-huh. I do that on occasion. So I'm going to get my happy signing brush. This is one. I love these new detail brushes, by the way.
Yeah?
They're not pricey, and they really, really work.
Oh, yeah.
So we're going to find a little spot to sign it. I'm going to maybe come along under the beard. There we go. Because you can sign or not sign.
Check
it's
that
up to
out.
You. As you finish.
Oh, I'm going to take that away so we can see it. Look at that. Oh, it's the inside. We can see that. It's awesome. Thank you guys for all coming and hanging out with us. We had a huge crowd here. Way over 250 people most of the time we've been here. A lot of our family and friends have we've seen here. And Gail and Steffi and Danielle and Brandy. And I saw Panda and new people like Freckle. And
Red Freckle. Freckle Red.
Yeah.
Cool name.
Yep. And
because my natural hair would be red and I got freckles. We got a bunch of that hair. We got short. We got redheads. We got freckles.
And
we got dark.
Mona and Colleen and all of our lovely friends.
I have something important I have to say to everybody.
Tell them.
By the way, you don't have to be happy all the time to be part of the happiness and the light in the community. I want you to remember that Eeyore, he was actually part of the light in 100 Acre Woods.
Yeah.
And he wasn't a deliriously happy little goofball. That wasn't his style. That wasn't his way. But he was there for his friends, and he always tried to be there for the people he loved, and that's what counts. So that was the other thing I wanted to say about if you're going through a time where you're feeling sad over the holidays, and everyone's telling you to just, like, jump around. If you're not a bouncy person...
You don't have to be.
No.
But Eeyore's love was felt by everyone.
That's all we're talking about, is that feeling of well-being and love.
Yeah.
Not about being like... You don't got to wear goofy hats and have purple hair and bounce around like me. You just got to be like you.
And Jack, he found his love and realized that, you know, it's everybody has a place in the world. And we get to love what we do and celebrate it. So thank you guys for allowing us to do this for you. And keep sharing your paintings. We're so happy to do this. We love seeing what you're doing. So, you know,
keep
I get
arting.
All squishy.
Paint for all the reasons. I'm gonna go play with my puppy. You guys have a great day. Bye-bye. See you with Easel really soon. Tomorrow for a really cool blacklight painting, which will be posted later today. So you can see it. You'll freak out.
Love you guys.
All right, bye-bye.